Hey everyone.
Is that it? You're not going to have anything more for an intro? Just hey? I mean, they're expecting you to have some kind of grand introduction, and all you're saying is hey. I feel if I was our viewers, I'd be disappointed in you, PTM.
And if I were our viewers, I would say shut the heck up.
Probably. But still, we are now going back to the guild, but we are still kind of nervous because, I mean, we disappeared. They obviously are going to be panicking. But, again, there's no reason we shouldn't have came here in the first place. Maybe it makes sense to not have Groval here, just because it will be easier to explain things without him here than if he was
okay.
here.
Okay, I must be the only Pikachu on Earth.
Yeah.
Because he's like, it's Pikachu!
Well, maybe you just have really odd feet. Maybe you're, like, mutated, or you have five toes would be odd for Pikachu. I would think.
Diglett instantly. Oh my goodness.
Okay, why isn't Dugtrio up here, too?
Dugtrio used Earthquake. Oh, never mind.
Yes, here's Dugtrio.
Yay, our friends. Wait, they're our friends, right?
Friendly friends.
Are they moochers?
They're friendly friends.
They're my vegetable friends.
Oh god, no. That video, I missed it. And it's really tough.
And they're cheerful.
Well, they're glad we're home. We're not dead. That's good.
Like, what? What was that? What? The secret. Oh, they told him my secret.
Secret. No, yeah, Chatot is basically going to sum up what we told them, everything learned. So, yeah.
So, Groval's good. Okay, yes.
He was collecting time gears to save the world.
Mm-hmm.
Dusknoir is evil.
Yeah. Seems legit. And I was actually Groval's partner from the future.
I was actually Groval's partner from the future.
Oh, no, I.
No,
was.
I was actually Groval's partner. Don't take my credit.
Well, the
I
real
am credit
Mega
to team.
400, please stand up. I'm standing up right now.
No, you're not. I am so standing up. Higher than you'll ever
I'm standing
see.
Up.
I'm taller than you. I am taller than you.
How tall are you?
I haven't checked, but I'm at least 6 foot, if not 6'1".
Dang it.
Why are you shorter than that?
Yes, I am. I'm shorter than Shadow Mario 41 by like an inch.
Ha ha.
But I'm taller than Slim.
Okay,
I'm surprised.
So Chatot doesn't believe us. He thinks we're all just lying, which you'd at least think we tone through somewhat. But yeah, Chatot is just like,
okay,
you're just delusional.
Let's walk through this now. We were dragged into the freaking time portal.
Well, hang on. Someone's gonna have logic here.
Someone has to.
And it's yeah, like, Chatot is like, there's no place called the Hidden Land, you're just doing drugs.
I love how the most short-sighted person in the guild is the intelligence department head.
Chatot's a good guy, he's just very stuck in his ways, I guess. Well, not, I don't know.
He's stuck in, his name is Chatot Freak 400, and he fights for
the
throne.
No, I'm not stuck in my ways.
Oh, here we go.
Yes, some Flora actually points out something.
This is another great use.
Good use of a flashback. But no, I'm not stuck in my way. I'm the one who was willing to adapt to the fact that Dusknoir was evil.
Okay, clearly they all just looked to the left, right there.
They're all looking at the portal.
What just happened? Why do you ask that question? You saw what happened.
And yeah, Sunflower is finally is saying, look, no matter what happened, it was strange.
Yanked them in.
We tripped.
We tripped and
yes.
fell into the arms of... In the arms of
the
Dusknoir.
No, I hate this song. Is so actually, you know what? That helps because usually it makes me sad. But thinking of Dusknoir and singing that song kind of makes it not as sad.
At least it's not in the arms of Hypno.
I thought you said something else for a second, and I was gonna be like, "Oh God, why did you say that?"
Come, little children.
You don't know what I was thinking. You said
what?
a person in history whose name starts with an H.
In the arms of Hitler.
No way! Oh god, now this song is so funny. Like, and it shouldn't be.
Okay, yep. So all the guild is sticking by us except Chatot at the moment.
Because Chatot is a traitor.
No, he's just stubborn.
You're a part of the Rebel Alliance and a traitor.
Hey, what does Chatot's voice sound like?
Chatot?
Yeah.
Blue blood.
I don't even know what his voice. He's British.
You think Chatot has what, like an English accent?
You're the one who said it. You said he was blue blood.
Blue blood?
You said that. What? I think you have short term memory.
Oh no,
loss.
He'd be hoity toity.
Oh.
Yeah, that'd be good. Hoity toity. Definitely him. Oh. I'm trying.
And the guildmaster believes us. And I love this scene right here. It's hilarious.
Oh. Was that off? Oh. Don't worry. Chatot believed them, right? Chatot believed them.
Chatot is convinced. He believed it all along.
Chatot is Smeagol.
Nah, obviously. Actually, this is kind of sweet because the guildmaster is sticking up for Chatot even though he didn't believe him at first. But I do. This is funny.
He was. So good.
It was a friendship test. See, obviously. Chatot is a good friend.
It's like testing our friendship. Friendship certainly is magic.
Okay, so now they all believe us, so now we are going to actually have help in finding the hidden land and, you know, all this.
Whoa!
Stuff.
Look what? At that. This is the first. Oh, never mind. I don't think we've ever heard Wigglytuff speak candidly.
We did a little bit when he was really wanted to get Grobot. When it's a serious matter, he does. It seems.
I think we only see that a couple of times in this game, where Wigglytuff is, like, without the music note. Because I noticed that Chatot and Wigglytuff both have, like, those music notes in their dialogue.
Yeah. But usually Wigglytuff lets Chatot do all the speaking. He is definitely his mouthpiece, so to speak. Okay, so basically everyone's gonna look for the hidden land or information, and I believe, I don't know if they mentioned it yet, but they're actually gonna send people off to Azelf and Uxie and them to tell them, look, let Grobot take the time of yours.
You're like, okay, I know we were kind of, like, against him and all, but now we're not.
Now we're not. We decide we want everyone to die, so...
What?
And Torkoal. That's interesting. Yeah, remember when I said they had no plot relevance? That has plot relevance. We have to go to the hot spring.
Yeah.
And, oddly enough, even though technically the plot spring is a whole separate area and a separate, it's in a different place, instead of just traveling there directly, we're gonna actually have to go through an old dungeon to get there. Which, you know, you think now that we know where it is, you would just be able to walk there, but obviously they wanted to make you go through a dungeon. That's the only one that you can go through to get there. And that dungeon, of course, is... PTM.
I do remember Waterfall Cave. Yeah, it's a water park in itself. It's so much fun. I would go through Waterfall Cave every single time just to experience that over and over.
And yes, we're gonna finally get some food in our stomachs.
Oh, yeah, Mega.
Hey, I'm hungry.
Okay, they could have done without Loudred. Loudred just made that whole thing.
Yeah, but it makes everyone, they're friendly friends. Anyway, this is the only time in the game at this point before the end game, or after you beat the main game, that you can actually use your Pokemon from your Chimecho assembly. Otherwise, and I think this is true, maybe you can take them out at a certain other point, but for the most part, going back to Waterfall Cave, you can take out Pokemon to go with you to Waterfall Cave. You don't need them, though, because at this point, you're really far ahead, and they're going to be, like, you know, a good 5 or 6 or 10 levels behind you.
So, auto attacks may be able to one-hit knock out a couple of the Pokemon there. That'll be fun.
Well, no, even if you brought, our Toro, SM and Toro's, Taurus and Sanju, Waterfall Cave should still be easy, because we're all really over-leveled for even that. But, you don't really need them. It's up to you whether you decide to take them or not. Regardless, we can finally visit Treasure Town, which is good.
Yep. I think this is also one of the few instances, little note here, that Chatot doesn't, force conversation on you.
Yeah, usually he's like, oh, you two, do this. But we already know
what he does. It's like, oh, you two, find jobs on the bulletin board. We're trying to save the world.
You two, do my laundry.
Laundry minigame. Okay, oh, yeah, so there was an egg here.
You have an egg that I dropped off a long, long time ago.
Yeah. So, I wonder what it's going to be.
And all the shopkeepers will be like, oh, it's good, you're good, you're safe.
It's actually a Pokemon I like. The egg hatched. Cacnea!
Woo.
You want to guess what I named it?
PK?
No.
Yes. Is it PKQ?
You're all going to die. No, I'm kidding.
Wait, Popo?
No.
PK3. That was so creative. Army of PKs.
Yeah.
Now, here's something that you should probably do. Someone mentioned that it's actually a good idea. You should probably delink Quick Attack with Pikachu, because Quick Attack can actually attack from afar. But to be fair, you also are going to learn a move pretty soon that can attack from afar. But,
We keep building up the suspense for that move.
Which should be actually, I think, immediately, really soon at this point. Quick Attack is, it can attack from afar if you don't have it linked, you might want to do some of that, because this is going to be like one of the last times you can visit Treasure Town. I think it's one more time. Well, there's a few more times, but we're getting pretty much down to the wire here. It's pretty much just...
I love that, too.
We have a ton of boxes we got from the future. Even more than these, I think. We have a ton of boxes. I had some still in the storage. Oh, what was that?
A Charmeleon Fang. I know, it shortens the name like Charmy Fang, but a Charmeleon.
I think it was Charum. Not Charmy. Not that I am the one to criticize pronunciation.
Yep. Mr. Tree Shroud Fortress.
Hey. It would be better if it was a fortress.
Cyndaquil.
Now that'd be useful if you had a Cyndaquil.
Yeah, but we have this freaking Chimchar.
Hey man, I'm a monkey. Don't be hating. So yeah, we're at the Kingscon store. Honestly, you could probably take all of these useless moves and sell them. Because I got a lot of moves from the future, a lot of the TMs, and you could probably usually sell all of those and just make a lot of money.
Yeah, you could do that. I don't know why I came back here. Well, you do. I was an episode ahead of that. We do come back here, though.
Yeah, we can come back. We do have to go back here, but not now.
Not now.
Yeah, did you put your money in the bank, or you still leave it out like I did?
I'm gonna leave it out.
Yay. Okay, so Waterfall Cave, this will be really, really quick. Hence why it's still, it's being a part of this cutscene video, because it's... You should have no problem... You should have no problem with Waterfall Cave at this point in the game. If you do, then shame on you.
Yeah. We'll see. We'll see how much a problem it becomes.
Wait, are you going to actually die here?
No. No, I think it's pretty much impossible unless you don't attack.
And at this point, you could pretty much, even with gathering items, you could pretty much just, as soon as you find a staircase, continue on. There's no real reason to explore, because you're not going to get much experience here, because you're so high level. The only thing that might be useful is if there's a certain type of Pokemon you want, you might want to, try and have it join you, because then you can try and, train them up, and being at a low level, if you train them against a little higher Pokemon, they'll, level up a little bit faster.
Well, we don't have time for that right now, actually.
We're not going to do that off-screen.
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, you could technically visit dungeons constantly before you go to the next story dungeon.
Yeah.
But But
for the purposes, you should be using gummies. Use gummies. Use gummies.
I will.
Gummy.
Eventually.
Gummy bears. When the... Oh, Psyduck. Oh, come on. You could have just shoved it in the storage. At least we could collect it.
No, Psyducks are dumb.
Hey, they're yellow.
I'm just gonna not talk.
Why, you don't have a comeback to that?
No, I have a thought, but I'm not gonna entertain the thought anymore. Anyway, Waterfall Cave.
That was easy, just to materialize on the staircase.
Five, floor six.
How many floors is this again?
Like eight.
I forget the date. It's amazing. I'm used to like 15 floor or 16 floor dungeons, and now we're back to like a really short dungeon.
Okay, this. I let this polywag chase me.
Just kill it.
Nothing.
Not gonna do anything.
No, but Slim's favorite.
Just kill it. Okay, floor 8. I think it's 9. Or, this is the last floor, I think.
I said 8, so we'll see.
This hello, Wishcrash.
Wishcrash. I have not seen it at all in this dungeon. It's weird.
You just saw it. And look, they did 2 damage to us.
Up until now, I had not seen it.
2 damage to the bubble attack. That's just sad.
Polywag water sport. Oh, that's cute. We'll let you guys listen to the music some more.
I actually do like the music here.
Because we never, I know it's not really kosher to pause during a Let's Play episode. Like, pause like Art's own speaking. But there's some good music in this game we've missed.
I don't know, some people like less speaking, some people like more, and you can talk to the Mankeys here.
Yes, you can. Well, Primate. Mankey and Primate. I wonder if they're related.
Probably. Primate brothers. Anyway, Torkoal!
he makes it a point to call us young friends.
Well, we are young, and we are friends.
Wait, no, we're partners.
No, we're friends
We're trusted Pokemon partners.
No, but we're friends with Torkoal.
I guess.
So yes, Torkoal does know of the Hidden Land, or at least, knows of it.
This is why I have a problem with Torkoal right now.
What?
He says there's tons of lore and legend associated with the Hidden Land.
And
he knows nothing about it.
It's like, there's tons of lore, not sure what it is, but there's tons of it somewhere.
I mean, there has to be. It's a famous place.
It's a Hidden Land. I mean, I'm sure someone made something up about it. I don't know what it... Maybe it has pudding. It's made of pudding.
Maybe the Hidden Land has jello pudding.
Jello pudding, Bob. We need proof. And he obviously is old, so he has a hard time remembering, but yeah, we need proof. But what is this proof? We don't know.
Do we need a mathematical proof?
Oh god, no.
I don't want to write.
I don't need to prove
that
it's a
again.
Triangle. We know it's a triangle. It has 3 sides. Don't need to prove it.
But you need to prove that those are sides that it has.
But it is, you can see it! They're sides! Screw math! Screw math and all of its
What's the word associated with the image? We know that we need proof.
So Lily Tell is being optimistic, but
yeah,
I'm not sure.
Hyper-optimist.
But we're not really sure where to go from here, because all we know is that we need proof.
We need proof.
We need proof. Well, we're going to keep trying, but until then, we're going to go to bed. Or eat. And then we're going to go to bed.
Actually, I'd probably go to bed an hour myself.
But we're recording.
I'll go to bed right now.
Oh, don't do that.
What?
Nope, no hope. Man. We're all going to die at the end.
Destroy us all!
Destroy us all!
Oh, man. I am just on it today.
Okay, well, next time, more stuff.